We'll just look at a few of these very quickly. So contextual targeting, as I've said, shows your ads on sites related to your shows and keywords. So I pick the keyword golf. It will then show my ads on golf-related websites because it's contextually matched. Your ads will appear in the best sites by matching the content of your ads to the content of websites. So this is the important bit. Sophisticated technology scans the web page, such as keywords, frequency of keywords, etc., to make sure your ads are placed in the right places. So you'll see on here, we have today's golfer website, and we have an ad for Puma Golf. Now, that's slightly different. That's contextual targeting. This one is topic targeting. So this displays your ads to users while they browse websites about topics. So it's not based on the content of the website, it's the topic. It's slightly, they're very, very similar, but there's a slight difference. So your ads will be displayed on quality sites that contain relevant content rather than the keywords that you've dictated previously. And they reach a broad audience and target the user in the most relevant pages of the site. This is the most important bit. So say, for example, we have on today's golfer, and we have, Okay, down there it says equipment. Puma, probably, in my opinion, probably should have done better topic targeting and put their ads under equipment. Because say I'm reading about courses, you might have an ad then for the local golf course doing a certain offer or a trip to the Irish Open or whatever it's going to be. Tips and tuition, you might find a golf pro trying to sell their wares on there. So you don't just have to stick this site-wide. Like say, for example, you use the Belfast Telegraph. Is there any point for you, this is a horrible example. So you're advertising the local party bus. You know, we've all seen them going along, taxis with disco balls. Are you going to advertise that above the obituaries? Pretty bad taste, yeah? So you can actually pick where you want these ads to appear. So maybe you're going to have that under the entertainment section rather than under that section. So you need to be a bit kind of cleverer about that and think what you're doing. You then have targeting based on people's interests. So reaching people that are most likely to be drawn based on the offering of your specific needs. Google looks at metrics such as repeat visits, frequency, to determine users' interests. So Google essentially pigeonholes all of us to say, right, this person likes that, the other likes the other. So we'll show this person that ad, this person the other one, and whatever else to anybody else. So this means that you can target highly relevant users with your ads when they're not browsing a site related to what you're doing. So it's very different to the kind of the topic and contextual targeting. This is me putting ads in front of people where I maybe think they are based on previous ticked boxes to the algorithm. So you then have, there's another means that we then can use, and it's a thing called in-market audiences. This is really, really new. And it's probably one of the better ones to be using. What this does is reaches audience who are actively researching products or considering actually taking something. Somebody in market is actively carrying out these things within 30 days. Google monitors their search patterns history in a rolling 30 days to say, right, do they tick these boxes? So say, for example, somebody looking at air travel, that might be somebody within the last 30 days that has visited EasyJet, Flybe, Skyroom, whatever it's going to be. And Google starts to monitor all of this and they say, right, how far down the channel have they got? Have they actually went to check out? Have they looked at prices? Whatever it is. And they allocate these people into an audience. So they'll say, right, this could be a luxury traveler, an avid investor, it could be an equestrian, somebody with equestrian interests, somebody interested in hotels and accommodation. But what it does do, it allows Google to base their targeting on affinity audiences, you allow Google to base people on their long-term interests. So say, for example, moving away from the in-market, which is 30 days, affinity works over, I think, 12 months. There's 80 different personas based on lifestyle and interest that map TV audiences to put people, again, into longer-term pigeonholes. You have things like do-it-yourselfers, foodies, luxury travelers, bargain hunters, all of these things. So Google basically looks at what you've been doing over a longer period of time, and it says, right, what do you fall into here? Now, we obviously don't have to fall into one category. We can fall into multiple categories. You'll have things in here like, I love this one, metalheads, sci-fi and fantasy TV lovers, business, what else, gamers. I'd be interested to see how you allocate a hardcore gamer against a casual or social gamer, but again, that's probably just down to frequency of how often people are using the sites. So what you can do, say for example, you produced science fiction figures, or you sell science fiction figures, you might go on and say, do you know what, I want to market myself to people that are in the sci-fi and fantasy movie fan section. They're hyper-qualified, they've had a long-term interest in this, they haven't just looked at one site once and then realized it wasn't for them and cleared off. They have a long-term interest in this stuff, so you're qualifying your audience the whole time. As I say, there's 80 of these. You have things under the affinity market such as fashion forward. These are people very fashion conscious. They're watching TV programs about fashion, design, makeover, trendy shoes aimed at women. You'll have example advertisers such as perfume manufacturers, cosmetics, designer clothes, and so on. So if you have one of these products, instead of you sitting going, right, where do I put these things? Just when you're saying about managed placements, what websites do I put these ads on? It's too obvious. If people are on those websites, there might be loads of other advertisers trying to do the same sort of thing. Why not get these people later on or before they've started to look to plant the seed about what you're doing by going where you know they're going to be. Somebody wanting to maybe sell perfume might go on to somebody when they're on when they're on Debenhams. They might have an ad coming up to them about that. It might be it's something entirely unrelated to what they're selling, but we know this person has a long-term interest, and that's why we target them. You have things like family vacationers, which is what I would now fall into, unfortunately. People that are on TV, they're watching family-friendly shows, kids' programs, and the kids' networks. They're reading travel magazines about attractions and sites for the family, rather than going to Sandals for a week, that sort of stuff. So example advertisers would be the likes of your Legoland, ski resorts, family-friendly hotels, all that sort of thing. There's no point in the likes of luxury retreats going to these guys. There's every point in Thomas Cook going to these people. Because they spent time, they're looking at these things over and over again, and they're becoming hyper-qualified. You then move on to the one that you asked about yourself, which is managed placements. This is showing your ads on specific websites that you choose. So you can basically go on to what's called the display planner, which sits within Google. You type in the website that you're interested in, and it will tell you if you can be on there or not. Equestrian stuff, you could go to Google and say, right, I want to be on Horse Weekly, if there is such a thing. I'm sure there is. So you can actually start to pinpoint and say to Google, I know where my audience is and where they're spending time. If you know that information, bang it on there and do it through managed placements. If you don't know the managed placements, what about using one of these things, one of these different targeting methods? Looking at your data to see where you are appearing and then moving it into a managed placement once that you know that it's actually very successful for you and focus where you know your user is, but not only that, where they're actually interacting with you as well. So you can handpick the websites and pinpoint relevant landing pages within that. So again, for Rolltac, you might go on to Horse Weekly under the products and services section instead of maybe the blogs and all that sort of stuff. Really, really categorically pick out where you want to be within your audience. And it's an effective targeting method if you already know where your customers are, if they're going to spend time on there.